Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome onto the campus of Taunton High School in the Alexio Tiger Stadium for tonight's matchup between the Taunton Tigers, who have been going through a rough patch lately, tank it on the Franklin Panthers. Alongside Aiden Humphreys, I am Dylan Clayman, and as I mentioned, Tigers haven't been doing so great lately as they lost 42-8 to North Attleboro and 35-15 to Everett. Aiden, what do you think the game plan should be tonight to pull this one out?
I think the game plan. You just have to stop the run. Because they've had trouble stopping the run for past two games, allowing 218 rushing yards. They need to stop the run. They need to get that done the minute the game starts. And I think against this team, you have that tenacity and grit, because they won 26-13 against Wachusett, and then 36-0 against Brockton. So I think this is a team where they have to have tenacity and grit if they're going to claw away a win.
At this time, with my next question, as Franklin has been rolling lately, they won three straight games. Aiden, how did the Tigers game plan against this to slow them down?
You know, like I said, you just got to bring the hard-hitting defense, and like I just said, tenacity and grit, because once this team has you down, they're going to keep scoring. That's probably how they won their past two games. So you just had to do that. You had to keep in the game. If you go a score behind, That's how you give away the game.
They can't afford any more of those.
No, we cannot.
League game tonight, very important. How do you see this one going?
I think this game could go either way. You have the Franklin. Obviously, they've been really good their past games. Taunton has maybe struggled, but you know they have the game plans all set up after the non-league game. So I think both teams have a very solid game plan established. I think Taunton can really claw away a win. I think Franklin might do it. This can be a game that can be either 35-28 or 21-14. You know, you don't know.
That's right. It's a huge game tonight. You're tuning in with us here, Alexio Tiger Stadium, Taunton Tigers, Franklin Panthers. Right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and football fans, good evening and welcome to Tiger Alexio Stadium for this evening's Hockamock League Kelly Rex matchup between the Franklin High Panthers and your Taunton Tigers. Captains out on the field right now for both squads, representing the Tigers, number 9, Elijah Prophet. Number 12, Dylan Keenan. Number 73, CJ Ramos.
That's why I'm a slide down.
Tigers to receive the ball. Fans, at this time we would ask all in attendance, if you would please, to stand, rise, join us as we turn to the flag for tonight's national anthem. Yeah. And a nice round of applause, as always, for our Taunton High School marching band. The color guard out here this evening, as well as the junior ROTC.
Johnny.
The visiting Panthers come into the stadium tonight with a 3-1 record, led by head coach Mr. Todd Kiley. The Tigers.
Hello, everyone, again, and welcome in to the first league game of the Tigers season. Tigers-Panthers on this chilly night. It's going to get very cold here tonight.
Oh, yeah.
And low 40s temperatures. I'm not looking forward to it.
I'm looking forward to the game, though.
That is what I, yep, exactly.
Cold stinks, but game's where it's at.
It's football. What do you want? It's fall. That's what you're going to get.
Yeah, Thursday night lights today.
I haven't heard that one before.
Oh.
It's usually.
That's because it's typically Friday.
Yeah, exactly. It's an odd place to put it because, you know, usually nice way to end your weekend, watch some football. But here we are, Thursday night, and we are underway. The kickoff to about the 10-yard line. It'll be taken back. It's going to get stuffed by the Panthers at about the 22-yard line.
You know, we start this game typical this time around. Remember last game that we commentated, last home game, started off with a return touchdown.
That is right. That did not happen here tonight.
Nope. We got a little bit of normalcy.
Tigers have returned back to the regular form here.
Ball spots at the 23-yard line, first down and 10. Junior captain quarterback Elijah, I'm sorry. Junior captain number 12.
And here comes the junior, Dylan Keenan.
Looking to lead
behind
the
center.
Tonight.
Yep. And on first and 10, they're going to run it. And that won't get them much. Maybe a yard or two.
Yeah, we're going to the going to what they love the most is the run game. This team really loves the run game.
They do, and they need to overall get their offense back on track.
Oh, yeah, especially after the past few games. But I think they can do it.
Mm-hmm. Yardage has been down. Got to correct some of this before the MIA tournament comes around.
Yeah, you know, I'm sure they can. You remember, these are athletes who got short-term memory, so.
Ball at the 25, second down. Play coming up.
Second and 9. Keenan will hand it off, and the Panthers see it coming right on it at about the 20-yard line. Oh, the ball seems to be out. Franklin thinks they have it, but
there's a loss on the play.
Ref rules it as third down for the Tigers.
Corbin Mello with the carry for the Tigers.
It looks like they have Corbin. They had Corbin Mello run the ball. We usually see him on primarily on the defensive end.
Mhm.
Maybe some surprises here already.
Possibly, yeah. Yeah, it looked like Franklin thought they had it for a second, but either way, it's not a good spot for the Tigers at the moment.
Oh no.
Third and long. Let's see what Keenan can do.
Third and long is the last way you want to start your first drive.
Third down.
Pressure on the Tigers' offense immediately.
He's in shotgun.
Now a high snap to Keenan. He's going to roll out right. He's going to flick it. And he will get the first down. Moving the chains.
That was amazing. I think Franklin expected him to run because he saw Corbin Mello in the motion. And I just caught him off guard. I think they went towards the. I think they went towards that direction, but they did not account for the flat.
Great play from the Tigers there to pick up that first on third and long. And now they are on first and 10 again at about 36-yard line.
Now I wonder what they're talking about in the huddle. What do you think?
They got to be talking about now they got some momentum going. They got to be working down the field now. They got to keep this going because Franklin is a high-powered team.
It's good to keep some simple goals here and there.
Ball at the 35.
Exactly. Just focus about the now. You can worry about the later when it happens, and this will be a pre-play penalty, and I believe this will be a false start on Taunton.
I saw the frustration from the running back. I believe that was number 9. profit. I saw some aggravation. I believe so.
Fans slowly piling in here, but doesn't seem to be as packed as it was for the first game of the year.
Yeah, first home game was absolutely packed.
Yeah, it was good crowd there.
Hopefully for the sake of the broadcast, we don't hear any obscenities being yelled from the crowd.
Yeah, you can't be having that. And here we go on second and 15. Keenan drops back. Pressure coming. Hand in his face. And it is almost picked off. But it is incomplete. Third and long.
Well, that was just, I mean, I think they had a good play there. Had a good play going. You had a man slant right to the middle. But the issue is, I think he kind of followed them with his head a little bit. That's a common issue anyway. But yeah, it was a good play nonetheless. Sometimes it doesn't fall.
Saber seemed to be open, but Keenan could not get it to him.
Now I'm wondering if we're going to get some more lighting here, because it's kind of hard to see the numbers.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a bit tough up here.
Second down and 15-yard play coming up.
Second and 15. This will be a fake handoff. Keenan will take it himself and will be pushed to the ground at about the 42-yard line.
That was an outstanding fake. That's exactly how you run around it, how you want to run it, because it got me fooled for a little bit. That was very impressive.
Good run from Keenan there, showing off the legs.
Have some substitutions. Looks.
Third and three here for Taunton. Don't know why I said it like that. Taunton.
Don't matter how you say it. It matters if you get it right.
Tiger offense looking to convert the first down.
And here we go.
Third and a short five coming up.
Yeah, I believe it looks like a pass. Man in motion.
See what happens. It is going to be a handoff. And Franklin will stuff it. Fourth down.
I mean, that was just a little bit of a tough drive. You know, maybe some growing pains from the offense. I think they can get – I saw some issues that they can definitely sort out as the game goes on. You know, first drive, it isn't always going to be going to fruition. But we're going to see how a Taunton defense does against this Franklin offense.
Special teams is on.
Tiger special teams. Onto the field.
And see what the punter can do. He's going to take it. He's going to boot it. It's a good punt. To just be on the 20-yard line. It'll be returned by Franklin. A good return here. Taunton will take him down to the 35. It's about a 20-yard gain there.
That was a 20-yard gain.
Yeah. Good run.
From the 20 to the 40. I remember the only issue of this defense has been stopping a run. We're going to see how we've game planned against it and if it can stop Franklin's run game here.
Franklin's offense is unique and it works.
I can see him wearing the pink for Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Very good.
That's right. And here they go.
First down and 10 play coming up for the Panthers.
And they will Justin shoot out with two receivers.
We see the blitz coming.
And this will be a keep by the quarterback, a fake handoff. It'll be thrown and incomplete, just a bit outside the reach of Kyle Walsh.
Honestly, yeah. Franklin's offensive line had really good blocking on that. I mean, if that wasn't an overthrow, that would have been dangerous. If he threw it any shorter, that would have been a good gain. But Taunton's defense, you know, I think they still applied a good amount of pressure because they forced him to roll out.
Indeed, it was a good drawn-up play, but could not convert on it. And now we have second and 10. Communication between the sidelines and the quarterback.
It's like some zone.
Here's the snap. It'll be a handoff. And he will run behind his lineman. for about a 6-yard gain. It's going to be third short.
Some solid running here so far.
Mm-hmm. Tiger defense has a chance to hold them
and
get the ball back.
Number 21, Andrew Frollo, on that last carry for the
Panthers.
Here
are cheerleaders trying to hype the crowd up.
Quick substitutions. Franklin is in a odd formation. And this is going to be a quick flip to the running back, and he will plow his way through for a first down.
That was an insane hit. I mean, even though we have headsets on, I felt that shockwave. That was an absurd hit.
Helmets colliding.
Oh, yeah. Looks like they advance to the first, and stay on the field.
Yeah, as I said, Franklin has a unique formation. And we are already seeing it here. There's a flip, and there's a flag on the field. As they flip to the running back, it's about 4 yards. Let's see what this flag is.
So now here's the issue with odd formations like how Franklin's is right now. It increases the chance of a penalty being thrown because you get some guys who – it's a very odd formation, so you get some guys who may not be adjusted or may not really expect a formation like that. So it commonly ends in some sort of hyperactivity.
And now Franklin has moved backwards. There is the ref over on the Franklin sideline telling him what the penalty was about. Play is halted here for the moment.
If I had to put my money on it, I'm going to say it was a false start.
That last penalty assessed against the Panthers will push them back.
They didn't signal false start. The ref didn't. He did something else. But either way, Franklin will be moving back 5 yards. Works out in Taunton's favor.
Very much so.
We now have first and 15.
Yeah, I think if I'm Taunton right now, clearly they want to go to the run consistently. I'm going to start blitzing because they've been in. I've seen zone coverage. Looks like they're going to blitz right now. But the cornerback seems to step right into his zone.
Might be no, five men coming. Quarterback escapes the pressure, throws it deep, and is incomplete. Once again to Kyle Walsh. He's gotten two good opportunities to catch the ball, but both times overthrown by the quarterback.
He's definitely been a target for them. I mean, I think Ton's done great at really just locking him down because that's what we want to do at the end of the day. Obvious answer, you want to lock down for number one option.
His jersey number is number one for a reason.
Oh, yeah.
As the quarterback, number 12, Justin Blanchetto, just can't seem to hit him. But here we are on second and 15. The snap is taken. Pressure is coming. He's rolling out to the right. He's going to flip it downfield. It is incomplete into the Tiger sideline. Third and 15.
Looks like the ball hit a photographer.
Yeah,
I saw the throwing of photographers go back. That was honestly impressive effort to roll out. But that was a great pressure by Taunton. I mean, that's exactly what they've needed to pressure the quarterback on the throw, and that's what they just did. I think that was amazing.
Hey, if you're on the field, you are not safe. You gotta have, your eyes open at all times.
Not even us.
Ball comes flying up here. Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of damaged equipment.
Oh yeah.
Oh, and very late substitution.
Looks like number 36 going out. That would be Brosnan.
Here goes Franklin. Quarterback's going to run it himself, but is, I believe, sacked behind the line to gain, and this will be fourth and 10.
That was like outstanding play by Taunton's DBs and safeties because they locked up any sort of passing route, and it forced them to run the ball, and they were expecting that too. That was outstanding game planning by Taunton.
The punt team comes on for Franklin as we have no points so far early on.
Now remember, last home game, Taunton special teams was definitely a game alterer. So we're going to see if their special teams can continue that that sense.
That's correct. For context, Durfee's punter, Franklin's punter almost gets blocked. That was a very slow release. And it's going to drop at about the 25. But as I was saying, the Durfee special teams had a very tough time punting the ball. There's the protection wasn't great, and neither was the punter himself. He was having a rough day.
You can't even put it on a punter. I mean, Taunton special team seems to always give the pressure on the punter. They see the punter as a quarterback almost.
Yeah.
So they really just put the pressure on, and I think that's what's caused them to win games in special teams.
Got to give Taunton their credit in that effort against Durfee. That was a 24-14 win.
That you do.
But gearing back to this game.
Second time for the Tiger offense out on the field this evening. Ball was spotted at the 23-yard line. First down and 10.
Keenan, first and 10. Will keep it himself. It's a fake handoff and will be ran for about 4 yards.
Yeah, well, it looks like they were not expecting the option on that one.
Yeah, it was two fake handoffs there. There are people calling Dylan Keenan's name. I thought they were calling my name, so I got distracted for a second.
Yeah, you get used to that.
I mean, when you say Dylan, you got to be more specific. And here we go on second and 5. Crowd waiting for something to cheer about, and the crowd has filed in.
Yeah, it's been getting filled recently. I mean, you have the entire right row
second
filled
down
out.
Five.
Here's a snap to Keenan. It's going to be a handoff to the running back, and he will fight for a first down. Great run there.
That was outstanding. I mean, just like last game, you have just these running backs, fullbacks. Texera again. Yep. Last home game, we saw him have a lot of persistent runs. So, yeah, I mean, another outstanding run for him. He can add that right to his resume.
Running back room has been pretty good this season.
Very good.
4:15 remaining in the first quarter.
Here we go on first and 10. This will be another run for about 4 yards. Second and 6.
Got to say, the run game, it hasn't been getting stopped as much. Looks like they finally have, that's kind of backhanded. But it looks like they have a game plan going on where the run blockers, they seem to force a great opening for a truck to go through and against the defensive line that's been allowing for, you know, either small gains or a big gain like the one we saw that very last play.
That is how I would describe the Taunton running backs, trucks, as they have fought and broken many tackles this season in efforts to gain more yards.
Oh, yeah. Like we said, it's all about persistence.
Keenan on second and 5. This will be a handoff, and this is going to be blown up right away. But he's going to escape the tackle. He's going to run outside, but he's going to be chaos on the other side of the field. But he's just going to be ending up right where the play started.
Yeah, I mean, yet again, persistency. Even though it didn't result in a huge gain like last time, it was still a very good persistent run.
There is a flag on the field. Let's see what that is. Refs discussing it. Yeah, there isn't a huge crowd of people outside of the gates as there was last time.
Well, I can see the coach Sidwell arguing from his side of the sideline. He does not seem happy at all.
Yeah, he doesn't know what we're holding the play for. Flag will be picked up. No penalty. Oh, wait.
We do have a flag on the field.
There is a hold on Taunton.
Assessed against the Tigers.
And now Russ running over to talk to Coach Sidwell.
He is very angry.
Who is heated.
I thought we were going to see a headset smash right there. You look pretty riled.
We don't have any Microsoft tablets here, so those cannot be broken.
Hey, I mean, the Gatorade bottles aren't safe either, those canisters.
Yeah, and Profit will come on for Texera for the running back position.
And that again, last penalty assessed against the Tigers will push them back inside the 35-yard line. Ball spots right at the nose of the 33, and it'll bring up a second down replay.
Tigers come out of the huddle with 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. And there are t-shirts or something being thrown into the crowd. Wonder what that is.
We can wonder, but we got to focus on the game.
But I'm up here as Keenan will drop back. He will launch it deep. And it is caught.
Oh, absolutely
beautiful.
Down
the sideline he goes. And he is tackled just short of the 10-yard line. Huge pickup for Tom.
That was outstanding rollout by Keenan. And that throw all the way to Jeremy Neef. That was wonderful. You cannot paint that up any better.
Great play from Taunton. Gets the crowd right in the game. And now Tigers are right in the red zone.
You know, Keenan identified the pressure. He knew right to roll out. You know, that was priceless, flawless.
Great throw from Keenan. And a great route run by Neef to get open. And now we have first and 10.
Tiger offense at the 13-yard line.
From the 13, Keenan will hand it off.
Hand off and a carry up the middle.
And won't get much there. Maybe a yard or two.
Carlos Cruz with that last carry for the Tigers.
No, it looks like we're going to go back to the run. I can see them going back to the run next play. Like I said, I mean, it's the first quarter. We're going to see two runs here, I'd predict, because you can always kick the field goal. 3-0 lead is no complaints on the first quarter.
Although that is right, you do want to get in a spot to get a touchdown here.
That is true, but I'm just implying the pressure is not as much.
That is also true.
Short yardage after that last carry. Bring
Keenan here will fake the handoff, pressure right in his face, and he's just going to throw it away from Franklin. Do not want to turn over there. Second down.
No, he did. Honestly, Keenan, he did what he had to do. He had to throw the ball away, avoid the sack. It's a sack in this situation. That would be terrible.
Good recognition from Keenan there. Just don't want to turn it over.
Or get sacked.
That too. Just avoid the pressure. Avoid the turnover. Just get it away. That's the best thing you can do in that spot. Don't try and risk throwing it to double coverage or something. Or getting picked off.
Best case scenario, deflected.
Third down play coming up there. The Tiger O.
Some sort of outrage, not sure where it's coming from, but Keenan will take it up the middle, and he will run almost into the end zone.
That is
just short.
That's as close as you can get it, and that's exactly how you want to execute a run option. The defense obviously expecting him to give it to the running back, but he takes it for himself, runs right up the middle. Great run blocking by the offensive line to open up a gap, and right now we see him, big chance at a touchdown right here.
We didn't see this much in the Durfee game of him using his legs, and he has used them to perfection here early on. Right on the goal line, 1 yard line. See if they can punch this in. It's just gonna be a quick handoff, and I believe Franklin will get him down short of the end zone.
Number 58, Jack Murphy leading the way, defensive lineman.
I mean, we're just doing what they got to do. You know, this is when you're at the goal line, you just have to punch it in. You know, throwing it on the goal line, obviously not the greatest idea. Quote the Seahawks in 2014.
Only 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Let's see if they can punch it in before the end of the first quarter. And Franklin will stuff him again, throwing him way behind the line.
Yeah, this is the rough part about punching it in the goal line is that you risk a sack or a tackle for loss.
And that will be the end of the first quarter. No score so far. And the two offenses, I don't want to say been struggling, but, you know, no points on the board so far.
I mean, you just got to say good defense. You know, it has been offensive struggling. It's been good defense.
We're still not enough at zero.
That is also true. As this will flip the field.
All right, Dylan, send it down now.
All right, let's send it down to our sideline reporter, Liv Graham. Liv, how's it going down there?
Thanks, Dylan. Tonight, the Tigers take on the Franklin Panthers. Tigers just got back one of their offensive weapons, senior Jake Nato. He had one catch for 18 yards against Everett last week. Tigers offense wants to incorporate Jake a little more. Go Tigers, back to you.
Thank you very much. As we go back to the game here. Start of the second quarter. Band entertaining the crowd. That is now filled in. The student section is very filled in now. It's good to see.
Yeah, it took long enough.
Blackout theme to perfection.
Very much so. I mean, I'm participating a little bit even.
So, yeah.
So are you.
I'm decked out. Come on now.
I got maybe a little bit too much red on me.
Yeah. I got nothing but black on me except for the black and orange shoes that, you know, go great with the Taunton Tigers theme.
Well, let's see if Taunton can start off this quarter of a touchdown.
Keenan will sweep it behind the line. They will get stuffed again. Just a reminder that they were on the 1 yard line and now see themselves at the 10 yard line with fourth down.
That is absolutely tough. They had great position, but you know, sometimes the everything goes your way. That is just how football works, unfortunately. Fortunately for us, fortunately for Franklin.
And on comes the kicker, Trinley Dudley. Let's see if he can put 3 points on the board for the Tigers. Snap, kick, good, 3-0 Tigers.
Right down the middle, just how you want.
Dudley's kick is through. And the Tigers.
So we finally have a score
after
the first quarter with nothing. 3 seconds right out the gate for the second quarter.
I mean, you can't complain about a 3-0 lead in the going into the second, or actually start of the second. It's nothing you can complain about. You can't always expect a touchdown that first quarter. You know, players are getting warmed up, ready to go. But I think we might see some. If plays have shown anything, we might see some. We might start seeing some explosive plays going into the second, third, even fourth quarter.
Now I will say one thing: as Taunton is getting ready to kick it off, that you do want to pay attention to these special teams plays because you know they have been pretty crazy here so far in this season.
Yeah, they do.
Obviously, you know, we don't want to keep bringing this up, but the Durfee return for the touchdown in the first home game and, you know, punts not going exactly how they wanted to, but you never know what's going to happen here.
I mean, how could you not bring it up? It just goes to compliment their special teams, and special teams leads to great wins, typically.
Franklin will get the ball back here. As it is booted away, oh, it's a squib kick from Dudley, and it will be recovered at the 15. And the return, he will juke some defenders and get to the 30-yard line.
That was a good run by Frollo. You know, I've got to give it to him. That was a good run, but yet again, a good squib punt. That's kind of how you want to do a squib punt. Yeah, hits the ground, bounces right down to the 20.
With the guest of Dr. Greg DeMello, chairman of the Taunton High School School Committee, we'd like to welcome some of the students from BNS, Bispo D. Manuel Ferreira Cabral School in Madeira Island, Portugal.
Tons of shout outs here.
Yeah.
Rodrigo, Diogo, Lucas, Carla, Mariana, led by Professor Angela Moraes. Hola, novos amigos. Benevido Escola.
And Franklin will get the. Franklin will get the first down here.
Let's see what Beyond Shadow can do.
It's a fake snap to the quarterback. It's going to be to the running back, but he won't get anything on that. Yeah.
That was a very dramatic, well-played play.
Yeah.
You know, if we're in a drama class, that would be an A+.
Great acting there from the quarterback.
I thought he got hit right in the eye.
Not that football would have been flying backfield, but Good fake by Franklin, but this will be snapped. Pressure coming immediately. It is thrown to the running back, though. He will get a first down and more, getting to about midfield.
I mean, that was Frollo has been, he's been a beast, it seems like. I mean, that was a good catch. He had good identification. He noticed that his quarterback was under pressure, so he ran right out, right for the middle, and he got him. But Taunton, great pressure on the quarterback. That is exactly what you want to do when you see that formation.
Yeah, the pass rush has been good so far, but, you know, obviously Franklin quarterback is not getting shaken by that. He is just taking his composure. This will be swung out to the left. Players crashing together. Just short of the 45-yard line. About 5 yards there.
Franklin's just starting to do what they kind of have to do at this point. You know, obviously the mid-route, long-route passes aren't working. We're going to start doing screens and all that. So, Baton, good job identifying it before it could end up a first down.
And here comes Franklin. See if the Tigers' D-line can get to him again. As there's only three D-linemen for the Tigers, but might be some pressure from the linebackers as well, and there is. This is going to be a handoff and another first down. Franklin is moving it.
They bet they are. They are moving it up.
Frollo with the carry. Jerry Beneath again with the tackle for the Tiger D.
I mean, I saw. It looks like I saw some late zone call. I think that might have been what led to a first down run.
An audible from the quarterback. Not too uncommon to see.
Ball inside the 40-yard line. Panther offense on the move.
And the offensive coordinator on the other side is screaming to the quarterback. Let's see what they're seeing on the field.
Let's see what he's screaming about.
Quarterback seems to be changing the play. And the ball will finally be snapped. It's going to be a pass. It's going to be thrown deep. And it is knocked in the air and incomplete. Great coverage. Great coverage from Taunton there.
That was outstanding coverage by Adomo. I mean, you can't ask for better coverage on that. He was one on one of them. He stayed on him the entire time, got in front of him once the ball was loose.
Brandon Adorno, senior.
Fans, again, a reminder to please make sure we're not standing in the main areas in front of the seats. Keep the aisles clean. Everyone, please find a seat and get comfortable this evening. We thank you for your compliance.
All right, let's see. Let's see what they can do here.
Second down play now coming up.
Franklin going here on second and 10. It's going to be a handoff to the running back. He's going to get about 6 yards there. Franklin keeps running the same sort of plays, like the fake to the fake quarterback, and then the running back takes it.
They really love their fakes. They love faking their plays.
Reminds you a lot of college ball.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of fakes and sweeps and stuff like that.
You got to wonder when it's going to stop working, because fakes, they only work for so long.
Halftime would be a big period for Taunton to discuss what's been going on the other end. See how they can shut it down. But here, with 8 minutes to go in the second, thrown out to the right, and it is incomplete.
That was great coverage by Taunton. All of the Taunton secondary, they're in their correct coverages. That was amazing. I mean, that's exactly how you draw up a defensive play against the pass.
With the pass play.
And
it was Rocha stopping that.
Yep. And it looks like, from our view up here, there hasn't been any change in personnel, so I believe that they are going for it on fourth down. And that is right. They're going for it.
They'll go for it, and I hear the fans chanting, watch the ball.
Down, it looks like the Panthers are going
and now they're chanting obscenities. Let's hope it doesn't pick it up.
For the Tiger,
and here goes Franklin. Drops, the quarterback drops back. He's going to flip it, and it is stuffed by Taunton. Fourth down.
Amazed. That's exactly how you play a fourth down. They immediately went to pressure the quarterback, and he got the ball. He got the ball to his running back, Follow too late. He got it to him too late, and he was available to get tackled immediately by the Taunton secondary.
Turnover on downs. Tigers with the great defense. I would argue all the way down the field, although, you know, Franklin was moving it, but they did have some good defensive plays. And they finally hold them before they can get some points.
So that's what I call the beauty of game planning.
Thank you for your support of Tiger Athletics.
And Keenan now back in the game. He's going to fake it to the running back. He's going to swing it out left. This is a big gain here. First down and a bit more.
I mean, hey, they were expecting him to run the ball with their running back. Nope. He froze it right to his left.
Hang on here. There's a flag on the play.
Of course there is.
We do have a flag down on the field.
Looks like it was holding. That is rough. That is not. That's not the call you want. You do not want that holding call this early, and or any time for that matter. That's tough, even after a good game like that.
We thank you for your support of Tiger Athletics.
I do believe the combinations have been getting better here in Taunton, as our PA announcer Fox has been announcing a new Snack Shack. Yes. Over in the south end zone, and the scoreboard now is showing the play happening on the field, so it's looking good here.
Yeah, we got some good concessions.
Might have to visit that halftime, as this is handed off to the running back, and he is stuffed by Franklin. Second down.
I mean, I think Franklin's just started expecting to run at this point, because it's obviously been an emphasis of both teams. So I think this is a point where we might see some more throwing with 7 minutes and 22 seconds left in the second.
Pound the rock has been the key.
As always.
Let's see what the Tiger offense can do after their big stop on fourth down. Ball snap, pressure coming. Gets a hand on him, Keenan escapes it. He's gonna fling it out.
That was to Neath.
Pass is complete.
And he will be out of bounds.
He identified the pressure right away. He rolled right out, found an open man. You can't draw that up much better when the play blows up.
It's good. Good throw under duress there to get it to Neath. Just before he runs out of bounds.
Looks like the fans are getting a little bit more excited here after that.
There is more. It's been more to cheer about in this quarter.
For sure.
Points and a turnover. Kanan will fling it to the middle of the field and is caught for a first down and much more. Great play.
That is a beautiful throw. I mean, he had perfect air on that ball. He had perfect spiral on that. He identified his man running to the middle. But you can't drop it up much better. That was wonderful.
Escobar and Neath have been his two main targets, I would say.
Oh yeah.
He's been getting it to them.
Tiger offense on the move.
I mean, why wouldn't you? They've been on fire.
Keenan will fling it out to the left. It is caught. A juke move is made. And Franklin thought that there was a fumble, but I don't believe there was. It's just going to be a four-yard game.
Got to respect the tenacity to try to juke the man out and keep running.
Yep.
But overall, you know, as like I predicted, we've seen more passing right here after the running game has seemed to be figured out. That was Antoine with the last reception.
Stopped at the 529 mark.
see. What do you think you're talking about in this huddle right now? What's the game plan?
The running has not been really working, I would say. The passing game, however, on the other hand, has been working. So I would say, you know, more passing. You know, Franklin has to find a way to stop it until you pivot away from it. But, you know, Taunton's been successful on that end.
Yeah, Franklin's focused too much on the run on the run game of Taunton. And, you know, it's been able to give Taunton some good open looks and some good routes.
Taunton does have threats at the running back position. And that was most likely a game plan for Franklin.
The ball at the 42 yards.
It looks like we're going to run a vertical with a man in motion.
It is a man in motion. Keenan will take it himself. Another fake.
Keenan again.
It's going to get to about a third and three, it's going to look like.
Hey, Keenan's done a really good job at using his legs this game. It's been good to watch. You know, you don't oftentimes see this many run options in the game unless it's like a third and one. But hey, he's been great.
He has been. So far. Don't know what the second half entails yet.
Well, you can only hope for improvement.
We want to keep moving along so everyone has room.
Now we've got a crowd. Look at this.
As we see Adamko sub out. He goes to the bench to hydrate.
I don't think you want that water to be too cold. You don't want to get too much colder.
In situations like this, colder the better.
Keenan's going to roll out right. He's going to sling it downfield and double coverage. It's incomplete. Taunton wants a flag.
That they do. You see Coach Sidwell. He is running on the field. He wants a holding call. And honestly, I agree with him. We have a yelling teacher on the on top.
And I believe
Walsh, he was holding Neef. He was holding it. He was grabbing at his jersey.
I saw that too,
On my totally unbiased opinion, that was a hold.
Yeah, absolutely. I saw that hold too.
And
it's gonna be fourth down. Fourth, it's short here. And I think this is gonna be a timeout for Taunton.
And a timeout on the field at the 4:14 mark.
Yeah. You know, Tigers, if they pick up this one, I'd say they're in a pretty good spot.
I'd say so as well.
Is that if they get that field goal or a touchdown, you know, it'd be a touchdown for Franklin to get, even if they pick up the field goal. And Taunton will be at a good spot as they have shut down Franklin throughout this game.
Something we knew that they could do. We had a feeling they could maybe shut them down, and that's exactly what they've done. They figured out their run game. They've allowed a few long plays here and there, but you know, they haven't allowed it to amount to anything. So that's really, at the end of the day, that's all you want.
Out of the huddle here, pressure mounting. Fans getting into it. And here we go. Fourth down. Taunton is going for it.
All right, fans.
Man motioning across the field.
Let's see.
Offense stays in the field as they go for it on fourth down.
Keenan drops back. Pressure coming from the outside. Keenan throws it deep. It is overthrown, incomplete. Franklin will take over.
That is a hard overthrow, but hey, he had the right target. He had a good route, you know, but it just doesn't always work. You know, one little thing can lead to a big incompletion like that.
Unfortunate there for Taunton as they had the momentum on their side. But Franklin gets a big stop. And now they have a chance to go to work from their own 40.
I mean, it's almost as good as a punt, I would say. Obviously, you want it down at the 20, but it's as close as you can get if you're going on fourth down.
You would like to be a little further downfield, though, I would say. But
well, obviously.
Yeah. But 409 remaining. Franklin will snap it, and it will be a keep up the middle here.
With their pretty peculiar formation, that seems to keep on giving them some good gains.
I'm getting confused.
I don't know how you even draw that up, but it's working.
You gotta be dialed in to see who has the ball for Franklin. This is gonna be another sweep pass, and he will be tackled just short of the first down. It's gonna be about third inches.
It is a. They keep running that same formation again. It is very peculiar. I've never seen anything like it. It looks like they want a tush-push.
Nope, it's just their formation. Runs out of the middle. The first down is gotten. Wrestled down. Yeah, Franklin just seems to be getting their little pickups here and there to get yards. And they just slowly work down the field.
That can be the name of a game sometimes, just small gains to get to that end zone.
Yeah, we're not looking at a high-scoring game, I don't think.
I don't think we are. Two good defenses going against each other.
And here is another run by Franklin. This one's going outside. He's going down the sideline. A broken tackle just short of the 10-yard line. What a huge play for Franklin.
Another good run by Frollo. I mean, he's been a beast this game. There's nothing else to it. He has been the absolute game changer for Franklin here.
Huge run. Very similar to the big pass Taunton had to get them in the red zone.
No, but thankfully Corbin Mello was there to stop before it became an end zone play. That would have been bad considering we only have 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in the second quarter.
Ball on the 14-yard line.
Yeah, not much time left. First down and 10 play. Really did not want a big play to happen, but it did. Run here.
Sidwell again with the carry.
About 3 yards. Yeah, Franklin's just going to keep running that play. Just like you don't know who's going to be flipped to.
3-yard
game.
Yep. And it's always that formation. You need to be dialed in to see who we're going to give the ball to. There's like three people they can just flick it to.
We are now down to just under 2 minutes.
2 minutes remain till the half.
And it's going to be a flip, and then another flip, and then right up the gut, touchdown.
And
Franklin.
And it was Cole Sidwell getting a touchdown against his dad's team.
Yeah, that was this just these plays where they just flip it, then they flip it again. You just don't know what's the direction they're going to go.
Keep flipping it. Just keep flipping it. It's like a Burger King ad. That was bad. That was a terrible joke.
Taunton hasn't been able to guess which direction they went there.
They've been having trouble putting the buns on a flipping burger. That was bad as well. As the crowd has fallen flat, half because of my joke, half because of the performance.
Oh, boy. Promise you all, we are almost done with this first half.
You will get a break soon.
But Franklin. Oh, there's a penalty against Franklin. The touchdown is now off the board. Wow.
Uh-oh.
I didn't hear that call.
I didn't either. I didn't even see the flag go.
Yeah, I didn't see the flag either.
Maybe a late call on this one?
After the play, maybe. Maybe it was during the play. We just didn't see it because the guy was in the end zone. But anyways, no touchdown for Franklin. And let's see if they can attempt to put it in there again. But this time, it will count.
I don't think the fans are yet to realize that the touchdown didn't count. Now they do, but as I was saying this, of course, they start noticing.
Yeah, there's obviously a big when they score, but yeah. You know, there's murmurs
and
after.
Even then, up until of course, when I start talking about it, they were just murmuring about it.
That penalty pushes the Panthers back to the 16-yard line.
And
replay of second down.
Franklin back in there, formation with everybody on the line. Flip, flip. Franklin runs it right up the middle, and another touchdown, but this time it counts.
So much for the penalty. Of course, it was Frollo again. He's been the big run guy for Franklin tonight.
Boy, that formation.
Keeps getting them. I have seen things fly onto the field.
I also just saw that. Yeah, we can't be.
We can't be doing that, guys.
Can't be doing that. I don't know who that was.
Whoever it is, apologize.
On comes kicker, puts it through the goal posts. 7-3, Franklin Panthers on top.
That was good by Essam, right down the middle, or maybe a little bit toward, I'd say a little bit towards the right of my perception.
Great kick, though, all around.
It was a good kick, yeah. I mean, it counted, so it would have to be a good kick to count.
All right, so we got 1:30 here. Aiden, do you think they're going to just run it out, or do you think they're going to try and, you know, get in range for a field goal or something?
I'd say they're going to try to get into range of a field goal. If they have enough downs when it comes to 10 seconds, I can see them just kneeling and letting the corner end. But overall, I believe they're going to have a pretty valiant effort to get the score at least 6-7. We thank you from Tiger Athletics. See if Taunton's special teams can have a good punt, or a good punt hit. I have forgot the terminology.
So you said
blocked punt. That's what I'm thinking of.
Oh, okay. We'll do start on that one. Here's the kickoff from Franklin. This one will land. Oh, it's dropped. Franklin is right on it. Let's see who has it.
Ball fielded and covered up by the Taunton.
Taunton will have it.
Oh, that is a big sigh of relief. It almost looked like Franklin got to the ball, but you know, luckily the man, he dropped down on it. He almost caught it, but hey, at least he fell on the ball to avoid any turnover.
We see
someone tying their cleats at the 30-yard line.
You know, from my experience in sports, when your shoe comes untied and the whole play stops just for you,
you're special.
It doesn't. Yeah, there's
special
a lot of
player.
A lot of pressure on you. Don't screw it up. You gotta.
No, but they're stopping for you, though.
Yeah, that is true. Yeah,
that means you're important.
Yeah, it's all on you, but you know you gotta hurry it up. Minute 30 to go. Tigers are just going to be handed off, I think, but Franklin still working at keeping them nowhere near field goal range.
Absolutely nowhere near, as we are still at the other side of the field.
Maybe Taunton was just getting to think that they're going to run it out, but maybe they come up with like a play action here,
hey,
try and throw it down the field, maybe.
You never know.
Never know, exactly.
We can see a four vertical right here. That's the greatness of football. You never know what's about to happen next.
To run under 1 minute remaining till the half.
As they didn't call timeout, so the clock continues to run.
Yep.
And fans, as always, please stick around for exciting halftime entertainment. Brought to you by the Taunton High School Marching Band. And the cheerleaders who have joined us here this evening also.
Kenan will snap it. Hand it off. It's going to be a run outside. It's a decent run. Gets out of bounds. Stops the clock.
That was a good, persistent run by Texera. Very valiant.
Amari Texera with that last carry.
Time running low here.
Knocked out of bounds.
Let's see.
Third down and short.
Will we see a deep pass here, do you think?
Or
are you going to keep running it?
Unfortunately, I think they're just going to play it safe.
Yeah.
Although they are behind. And Franklin will get the ball at halftime. I mean, after halftime. Excuse me. Make sure you stick with us at halftime, though. The band will make a performance. So don't want to miss that.
No, you don't. They are great performers.
They are a great band. Lucky to have them here. Kenan, snap. Handoff. Oh, it was a keep by Keenan, and it was fumbled by him. Franklin looked to hop on it.
Yeah, a loose ball on the field, but
that was just rough. That was
Keenan did recover it though.
Thankfully. Yeah, I thought he gave it to Texera. I was about to get excited. I thought that was a wide open, all green run to the end zone, but yeah.
They have been doing that, you know, handoff and then keep by Keenan.
That would be the option.
All night they have been doing that. Obviously there did not work how they intended it to.
Nope. Actually, I think it worked the exact opposite.
This is going to be fourth down for the Tigers. Yeah, they're just going to punt it away. Obviously, you don't want a big return here.
No, you do not. But Taun special teams, you know, we have hope in them. They've been very good from what we've seen.
Snap to the punter. It's going to be a high punt and a short punt. To about the 40. It's touched. Franklin's got to cover it up, and they do. At about the 30-yard line.
They avoid exactly what we said they wanted. They wanted to avoid. They avoided a big run off the punt return.
Yeah, just a reminder there. Like, if anybody touches it, it's a free ball. It's anybody's ball.
Oh yeah, any man's game.
When someone touches it, so someone accidentally touches it, you got to cover it up quick, or else it could be going the other way. 9 seconds here in the half.
Let's see. Do you think Franklin's just going to play it safe here? Just let the quarter run out, or do you see a four vertical?
Nah. I mean, we can only hope, but, you know, obviously not. Probably not.
Well, given we are Taun broadcasters, we'd hope for him to play it safe so we can just go into next quarter. Because you never know if that four vertical might work.
Yeah, they are up 7-3, and they do get the ball. So they are in a good spot right now, Franklin is. And not sure if this is
another weird formation.
Pre-play flag here. It's going to be, I think, a false start. Might move them back 5 seconds. And it will be on Franklin. 5 yards, back him up. Now,
this will be a pretty long 9 seconds as they look to play it safe, it seems.
When we come back, it might be a little colder.
Oh, it definitely will be a little bit colder. But we do it for fan enjoyment.
Exactly.
And so the players can show scouts how great their commentators are.
It's all for the people here. Yeah, this is a great run outside to pick up 6 yards. And well, they run the. Yep, they let the first half run out.
Oh,
there's whistles. Hold on. Nope. Get back here. It is not over.
Nope. It looks like they called a timeout right before the time expired.
Yep. 1 second left is correct. Not really sure why.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like in this situation, you're down at your own end, at the 30-yard line to be exact. I feel like this isn't a situation you just let the clock run out. Am I seeing that right? No. On the scoreboard, it says 0.2 seconds.
Yeah, it's not much time, is it?
Yeah, not at all.
But in football, you know, one play is...
Yeah, one...
One play. Yeah. It doesn't matter if the clock runs out. The play still happens, so... Clock doesn't really matter. It's just one play.
No, I still think it's quite humorous that there's 0.2 seconds left on the scoreboard.
Yeah. That's an interesting amount of time.
I mean, it shows the clutchness of a coach. He was able to call a timeout right before it expired.
The composure you see here
is all about composure.
Insane.
All about composure.
Cannot believe what you will see here. You will see anything. Yeah, one more play here for Franklin. And finally, they are in the shotgun.
I think we're going to see a deep pass here. Trying to go for it.
3 seconds remaining. This could be the last play of the half.
He's going to drop back. Is he going to throw it deep? Oh, he gets hammered. And that is how the half will end.
What a hit. That was an insane hit. That was number 8, I believe. Dudley.
Football
here at Tiger. That was.
That's not how. You know, doesn't matter. That's not how you. That's not how you want the half to end. Your quarterback getting drilled.
Yeah, grilled is the correct term. He got absolutely thrown around.
All right. End of the first half. Franklin leads 7-3. They will retrieve the ball in the second half, and we will see you there.
We thank you for your support of Tiger Athletics. And as always, an excellent halftime presentation now with the Taunton High cheerleaders and then the marching band. Nice round of applause for them, as well as our guests from Franklin, the young ladies from Franklin, the Lady Panthers cheerleading team working hard over on the opposite sideline.
we got in the third quarter.
Welcome back. Second half action from Alexio Tiger Stadium. Taunton trailing to Franklin 7-3. Let's send it down to our sideline reporter, Liv.
Thanks, Dylan. Both teams' defense are off to a great start with explosive stops and lots of blocking. Tigers' passing game has also been extremely well today. Dylan Keenan had a really great throw to Jeremy Neef in the end of the first quarter. The quarter almost gave them a chance to get in the end zone. Walking out to just come out as strong as the first. Back to you, Dylan.
All right, thank you very much. Back up here for the second half. Let's see. Aiden, what do you think the key is for the Tigers to get back in front?
The key for the Tigers right now, you have to stop Frollo. He's just had his way with the defensive line, and their offensive line as well has been able to make pathways for him. So, that's really the main goal, is just to clog those pathways, stop Frollo, and I think that's the keys to win the game right now.
Yes, Franklin, as I said many times, the unique formation is
been
very troublesome for Taunton defense.
It will be troublesome for anybody. It's a very weird formation.
That is right. And the kickoff will be a squibber to the 15. It will be recovered by Franklin, and he will run it up to about the 28, where he is bombarded with Taunton players. And on comes Franklin offense.
Colby Ryan, I mean, he stayed up for a lot of hits, but they are around where they'd be as if they did a fair catch or touchback.
Mm-hmm. The Franklin offense comes back on the field, who had a touchdown taken away from them, and then they got it right back the next play.
And you cannot forget the timeout when there's 0.2 seconds on the clock.
That is also right, yep. And here comes Justin Blanchetto, the quarterback for the Panthers.
Let's see. I mean, we did see some good routes in that first quarter, but he just, you know, slightly overthrew Walsh on both throws. Let's see if they go back to that.
That was earlier on in the game.
That's why I said first quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Back in a weird formation.
Back in their formation. It's going to be the two sweeps. And the Tigers definitely talked about it. And they stuff it on the first time it is run.
As we predicted, I mean, the fake can only last so long. I mean, eventually we're going to expect it. And obviously, they definitely discussed this in the locker room at halftime. They're not going to allow this to slide every single time.
Coach Sidwell probably said they're going to flip it once, and then they're probably going to flip it again. So be ready on the side of the field in which the quarterback hands it off, as he will be coming by that way. And back in the same formation. Let's see if the play is different. It's going to be a keep by the quarterback.
Yeah, it looks like Taunton has completely figured it out. They have figured out how their formation works, and now they're going to force Franklin into an uncomfortable position, which is changing their formation.
You know what I have noticed is that they seem to switch quarterbacks. I have noticed that they switch off from Blanchetto and Will Terrell on the court in the quarterback position. I said.
See, now we have Blanchetto in the shotgun.
Third and 10 play now for the Panther own.
He's gonna drop back. He's gonna launch it to the left side of the field, and it is incomplete. Looked like it was caught at first by Walsh. But then the ball hit the ground.
Pass is broken up.
And is ruled incomplete.
I mean, even though that's not the result you want, that is the play you want. I mean, he did get the ball to his receiver, which was Walsh. That's exactly what you want to do. Just the ball hit the ground first, and there's nothing you can do about that.
It is fourth down. The punt team for Franklin comes on to start the half.
Taunton special teams bringing the pressure again.
That's going to be a low punt. And they're just going to let it roll. And Franklin probably picked it up too early, though.
Yeah, and that was Sidwell picking it up once it hit around the 25 line.
Yeah, probably could have let it roll a little more.
Where? Go to the 23?
And as I did.
I mean, every yard is, that 2 yards would be a game changer.
I did hear, by the way, that you just mentioned last name Sidwell. I did hear that he is Taunton Tigers coach, Coach Sidwell's son. I did hear that.
I heard about that too.
Yeah, so that's a pretty interesting rivalry going on there.
Very interesting. Not something you see often.
Yeah, they'll be talking about that later. And here comes the Tigers again here on offense. And we have two running backs out there, Prophet and Texera. And it will be handed to Texera. Up the middle. Good blocking from Taunton. He is still pushing his way upfield.
It's always him.
And he'll be stopped right around. I don't know if he might have got the first down, but what a great run from
Texera,
yeah.
It is always Texera. Texera with these valiant, just persistent runs. I mean, he can have the entire defensive line on him, and he's still determined to get as many yards as he possibly can. And like you said, good blocking by Taunton, for sure.
Great blocking, and that does move the chains for a first down.
See, it looks like they're running the same formation.
Yep, here they come again with the two running backs. This time it is Prophet.
Tigers keep it on the ground and pound.
And he also is pushing, but will be tackled down by Franklin. Yeah, they don't want to go down. That's their key. They just don't want to go down.
They do not. I mean, that's what makes this running back duo of Texera and Prophet very special. I mean, you don't see two high school running backs often just be able to plow through just like tons of defensive linemen and safeties. This isn't something that's like common.
Very good at plowing through defenses along with good blocking.
Of course, the offensive line's been improving.
Tigers keep it on the ground.
It's a run up the middle. It's going to be a first down. Texera once again.
Oh, well, it looks like the run game is the way to go. It looks like Franklin actually halftime planned for the pass.
Yeah.
That's what Taunton was getting going in a second. And they just became oblivious to Taunton's biggest threat, which is the run game.
Tiger offense on the move.
That's what I was going to say, yeah. That they probably switched plans now. That Franklin discovered that the Tiger passing game has been good, so they're probably trying to prevent that. And then Tiger said, let's switch the run game now.
Hey, the thing that works for them relatively. As I smell, food in the stands.
Oh yeah, they got a huge snack thing outside. Have not visited that because
No, I was too busy getting food from family members.
I was not prepared for there to be this much concessions. And there's gonna be a timeout from Taunton early on.
Very. What do you think this timeout's about?
Not sure. Maybe just to like, maybe hydrate. Yeah, I see them a lot of grabbing water. They seem tired.
You know, just hydrate, take some deep breaths, and be ready to continue what you've been doing.
Yeah, from their runs that have been taking a lot of energy out of them, probably just gather them.
Yeah, well,
regroup.
When you're plowing through 5-6 guys, I'm sure that'll be pretty tiring.
A lot of energy, big. Put into that.
Hey, but it's good energy.
Great energy.
Outstanding energy. We can think of endless words here.
Well, we do have a football game to call here.
Yeah, we do.
And
no spelling bees.
Keenan gets under the center. He's going to hand it off again. And there's a fumble in Franklin. And the ball is still on the ground. Franklin will recover.
Yeah,
Franklin's ball.
That was recovered by Weaver. That is the only downside to running the ball. That's just detrimental. That hurts.
Yeah, ball popped out. Franklin had it and they lost again. Then someone else recovered it. And now they're looking great coming out of this half. All the momentum.
Thankfully, they are still on the other side of their field. I mean, of the field. I don't know why I said there.
So now the field flips in Franklin's side. We'll try to push it in for points. Getting 3 points here would be huge. Push it to a touchdown game, but getting a touchdown would put it to 2 possessions, which would be tough for the Tigers to overcome.
Especially in just 2 quarters.
Hand off to the running back.
I saw a flag fly.
And that's going to be about a couple yards short of the first.
Because I thought I did maybe a fan.
Yeah, it was something else. Yeah, that wasn't a flag.
A fan for something on the field whatever reason. 7 yards
on not sure what happened there. Not sure if that was.
It was from the Franklin side. It was from the Franklin side, too.
I don't know. We don't have a great view up here.
We didn't.
Just to be fair.
It was just some gray thing I saw fly. So.
We can't make assumptions of who it was from.
Nope. But it did come from the Franklin side. I don't know what they're mad about.
I mean, there is a lot of Franklin fans. I haven't even noticed them over there on the other sideline.
Pretty packed.
Yeah, they do come out and support their team as their team gets another first down.
I think that was... Frollo again. I mean, he's been the guy. You know, I feel like we've been mentioning his name seemingly every single offensive possession for Franklin.
Yeah, he's been great tonight. He's been moving the ball for them effectively.
Very effectively. I can hear the fans getting amped up. They really want their team to win. I hope so.
It's Thursday night under the lights, man.
Oh, yeah.
You have a lot of, I mean, if you're coming to these games on a Thursday night, you have a lot of pride, and that's what these fans are showing tonight.
As a quarterback ready to get the snap.
This will be a handoff, and somehow when it looked like the play was going to be blown up, it is still fought for about 5 yards. This is a great running unit from Franklin.
It really is, specifically Frollo, but... there's nothing you can do about that. Ton, they almost blew it up, but he just broke those 2 tackles as if it was nothing. So there's not really much you can really do about that at all.
Cheerleaders trying to get the student section into it, but, you know, not much. No, not much going on over there.
Other than a few screams, it's been pretty stale.
Yeah, not much to cheer for at the moment.
That'll change. We can hope.
Well... we'll see.
That's why I said we can hope.
We'll see.
If not, go to a concession stand.
Second down. Handoff. Another handoff. Another first down. Boy, this Franklin Panthers team is just good team on offense.
Well, I mean, I wonder if the listeners can guess who ran the ball again for a good gain.
Oh, yeah.
I'll give them the answer quick. It was Frollo again.
Great player. Yeah, he's looked good so far. Definitely their main weapon on offense.
I mean, they've made it quite obvious. But I guess he has enough skill to really make it the obvious. Just over 5 minutes remaining in the
third. And in the shotgun, it's another handoff, and this one's going outside. This could be a first down, and Moore, he's going to be in the red zone. About the 12-yard line. A great run there for the Panthers.
Yeah, that is just, I mean, this run game has been ridiculous. I don't think I haven't seen Franklin have this dominant of a running possession than this. This is impressive. I got to give it to him.
Boys getting cold. There was a small breeze. That was a cold one.
Yeah, my hands are absolutely freezing. My partner Dylan Clayman, he has his gloves. I don't.
Yep. I came prepared, man.
He did.
I look at the weather report.
I did, but I didn't care.
And now he prays pays the price, ladies and gentlemen. Run up the middle to about the 5-yard line, just short of the first down.
Now, how much you want to bet they just keep running it?
It's worked so far. I bet a lot.
But what if they pull off a 2014 Seahawks? You know, that's something that the Taun fans really have to hope for right now.
Ball spots at the 6-yard line.
If Franklin punches us in, then, you know, Tigers really got to get going because not much time left.
Clock running under 4 minutes remaining.
Hey, sometimes pressure is what brings out the best in teams, you know? This could be a learning experience.
When the lights are the brightest. What? When the lights are the brightest, what will you do? Franklin is showing that they will perform at a high level. And this is going to be plowed right through. And I believe that is a touchdown for the Panthers.
He just dived right in. Taun's trying their best. I mean, you really have to go with Taun. They are really trying to attempt to stop him. But this guy is just can't stop him. You can't stop this guy.
Yeah, it's a great offense all around with great blocking.
I think my question is, why isn't he playing college ball right now?
He most likely has a future in that.
And he's most likely too young to be playing.
And there is a kick, and the kick is good.
Right down
14-3, Panther lead.
The kick from Owen Essam is good.
The Cat Bowl.
The Cat Bowl, you would be correct. This is the Cat Bowl.
Remaining in the third quarters.
Which cat is stronger?
In real life, I'd assume it would be a tiger.
I'm taking the tiger in real life.
And the game.
Right here, I might go with the Panther. So far.
Well, I think you're being pessimistic.
I'm just going off what I've been seeing.
Hey, Tigers perform under pressure. I'm not sure how credible that source is, but
yeah, just a reminder on your screen, you see 3-1 for the Panthers. They have won 3 games in a row. Some by a wide margin, and Tigers lost 2 in a row, also by a wide margin.
Yeah.
So Tigers really looking to get back on track here, but Franklin has been rolling.
I wouldn't say rolling. I mean, in the first 2 quarters, they were getting stuffed at most times.
I was talking more about the season, not the game.
Oh, whoa.
Oh, this is a return from Taunton. This is going to go to about 37, a great return. Put him in good field position.
That's an outstanding return. I mean,
yep.
For a return like that, it can't draw it out much better. I mean, I feel like there's good blocking by the special teams to really allow him to get some leverage.
That was Texera, the running back, slash kick returner. Kick returner, yeah.
Yeah, you would be correct.
I was confused. I was going to say punt returner, but that was a kickoff, yes. Keenan back on again.
Let's see if it can. I think they can get this game competitive. I really do.
I would assume this is a pass, as there is 3 receivers on the outside. But we will see. Nope, it's a handoff to Prophet. He's going to fight for yards, but he will not get them. Only about 2 yards.
I mean, the run game was working for a little bit, and it seems like after they called that timeout, they might have accidentally gave Franklin enough time to plan. But I think this is when we might see a little bit more urgency in the air, I believe. I believe we might see a little bit more urgency. They might start throwing the ball.
We shall see what happens.
Yep, unpredictable. That's the sport of football.
In the alt area. And in the front row of the stands.
We'll see. This student section is absolutely packed.
And it actually just keeps growing. I mean, there's still people coming in.
It is a packed section.
Second down play now coming up for the Tigers.
As Keenan froze it, he threw it to his left.
Can't do it, yep. I was looking at the crowd. My bad on that one. yeah.
I can always play both roles. No big deal. But don't. I'd prefer not to.
Yes. Yeah. I'm here for a reason, aren't I?
Yep.
Third and 6 here for Taunton. And the Franklin Panther defense looking good on this drive.
Pretty good. But let's see if Taunton can outdo them. As they huddle up, I assume they're discussing what they should do, as that is what huddles are. That was a blatantly obvious thing to say, but it was getting too quiet.
You can let the game breathe. You can. as this is Keenan throwing it deep on the left side, just a bit overthrown. Had him open, could not hit him, and now they face fourth and six, which probably means punt team comes on.
Hey, I mean, I think he did do a good job at, he saw the pressure coming, he was able to get it out, he was able to avoid, he was able to avoid.
Yep, you got it, yeah.
Grounding.
Yep.
So, yeah, I mean, I think it was a good read. He was able to get it accurate enough to get in the direction of the receiver, and, you know, sometimes it's just overthrown, he put too much power into it.
Yeah.
I don't know why it took me so long to say that.
It's okay. Maybe the cold air is getting to you.
Cold air and a Red Bull.
For those of you that don't know, I don't know if he mentioned it or not, but he did have a Red Bull at half, as this is going to be to the 4-yard line as a return for Franklin.
Now, I mean, this is a possession where, I mean, this is going to be another plainly obvious thing. But you have to stop him this possession. This is a I feel like this is a do or die possession to stop, because
is,
I think if it becomes 21-3, it's not looking good. Not looking good. And sorry to any Falcons fans, but unless a choke like that happens again, we probably won't see a Tiger win.
Yeah, it's only two more touchdowns. We're looking at 28-3. Obviously, you know, that's not a spot you want to be in, but
it might be, you never know. If they hit 28, it might be a cursed number.
That would be all over the news if that happened.
Oh, yeah.
But.
And they talk about the two amazing commentators discussing.
Ball spots at the 39-yard line.
Might be clips of us in that article. As this is going to be a snap to the quarterback. He is going to bobble it a little bit, but he will hand it off. And this will be another Franklin first down.
Their run game is just very run blocking. They're outside running. It's just been, it's all been right. It's all been right. It's Frau Low again. I feel like it's just redundant to say it. I feel like at this point I can just say that they ran it and the listener would know.
Yeah. But, you know, time running low in this quarter. And you really, got to hold them to less than a touchdown here.
Yeah. Even a field goal, you still have a shot to mount a comeback.
Yeah, because that's still, you know, two scores. But obviously three scores is a lot harder to overcome.
Significantly harder.
This is going to be a handoff to the left. And this is going to be another first down and more. Franklin just keeps pounding the rock, and it, boy, is it working.
It's been the outside run. I've noticed that when they go inside, Ton seems to have them figured out. But on the outside, their outside run blocking has been almost flawless.
15 yards on that last carry. Taking it down now to the 39-yard line.
I mean,
34-yard line.
Blanchetto, the Panthers quarterback, must feel great about the offense he has around him.
Oh, he has to.
And the Panthers side, Panthers fans must feel good about their football team and how far they can go.
Especially in a tough environment.
Yeah. How far they can go in the playoffs. They're a good offensive team. And even as the Tigers seem,
they did
hold him back, but they could have had him for a bit more, but broke that tackle, still was held behind the line.
You cannot complain about a tackle for loss. They read that one like a book. They read that one like a book. I think they're now getting adjusted to that fake as well. I think as Franklin keeps doing these fakes, Tons is going to get used to it at this point. I think they have their eyes on the quarterback at all times to see what he does.
Another one here for Franklin. It's going to be second and long. It's going to be a fake handoff. Rolling out right as the quarterback. He's just going to keep it himself, and he's going to pick up the first down, trying to avoid contact there, but he does his job. Moves the chains.
That was a very interesting dive.
Yeah.
hey,
more of a panic move, I would say.
Yeah, panic dive, but it was a good run by Beyond Shadow. I got to give it to him. That was a good fake. That was a good fake. I had to hand it to him.
Yep. Great play there, and all around it's just been great. Great day for Franklin.
As there's 5 seconds left in the third quarter, I'm guessing they're going to just run it, as they might want to start chewing clock at this point. As they have a man in motion. Quarterback and shotgun. He hands it off. It was.
That's another, yeah, handoff. It's going to get about 4 yards there. Yeah, not much there, but still moving down the field.
Yep. As you have the the fans yelling Fiend for some reason. Why, I don't know. But that causes the end of the third quarter.
Yep, third quarter at the end. 14-3. Franklin threatening another score. Taunton's really got to stop him here. How are they gonna pull this one out if they can?
If they want to pull this game out, they have to keep the eye on the football and the quarterback's eyes at all times, because at this point, they'll get a fake and it'll get stopped, but then they'll do another fake and it's like the last one didn't even happen. So they have to just keep their eyes on the ball at all times. Like, I feel like that's obvious, but yet again, it has to be said, because that's the way you have to beat them. And also, they forced them out of that weird formation. That was step one. They force them out of a weird formation, but now they just keep doing fakes. So I believe once they identify what causes a fake, what isn't a fake, I believe that is what can put the game in Taunton's favor.
Don't be afraid to speak the facts up here.
Oh, I'm not.
Doesn't matter if it's obvious or not. You gotta tell the viewers.
You gotta tell them. The viewers. You also gotta make sure it's not too quiet.
That's also right, you know. Gotta keep them entertained down the stretch here.
Yep.
But it is a good game overall.
It has been entertaining, very gritty, as we may be expected.
Yeah, low scoring, only 17 points scored by both teams.
You know, it's been two good defenses. Just one team has a running back who can seem to get past anything.
Has the edge, yes. We are in the last quarter of play.
Second down play coming up.
And let's see what occurs here. And now there's a pre-snap penalty. And, yep, from the looks of how mad they are, it's on Franklin. Boy, were they mad.
Oh, they did not seem happy. I don't know why exactly you would be mad in this situation. This seems just a small inconvenience.
Yeah.
You know, whatever floats their boat.
pushing out of field goal range, yeah. They do want to try and score here to put it potentially out of reach for Taunton.
Hey, you never know, the most crazy things
can
happen.
Yeah, you never know, yep.
We might see another kick return or punt return, depending on how this goes.
You do wonder what the biggest score overcome by Taunton is. I do wonder that.
I wonder that as well. I wasn't able to really get that info.
We're gonna have to do some deep digging for that, and that is blown up by Prophet.
That was beautiful. I mean, we heard that from here. That was a shockwave.
Boom.
Oh man. I mean, that just gets you pumped up. You know, that gets you absolutely pumped up. It gets your team hyped. It gets the fans hyped. It gets everyone into it.
That's a big hit there.
Oh yeah,
that's a play right there. It doesn't even have to be a turnover or nothing. It just has to be a big play that gets the crowd into the game. That shifts the momentum
and gets your guys ready. I mean, when your guys see a hit like that, I mean, it's hard not to be. We're motivated up here, and we're not even on a team.
And here comes Franklin again. He's gonna drop back. He's got plenty of time. He's gonna throw it much short of the mark, but there is a flag on the field.
He had a right read. He just kind of underthrew it. It looks like his target was 13, Stephon Reed. I hope that's how you pronounce it, Stephen Stephon.
You know, we haven't had any parents come at us for mispronunciations yet, so I think we're all good.
Yeah, I think we're all set.
Yeah, people make mistakes.
Yep, we're human too.
Yeah.
Believe it or not.
Just as most substitute teachers tell you, if I screw up your name, please tell me.
Penalty is
that is on Franklin. Fourth down. and very long. And I would assume, and I'm not sure.
Offense stays on the field.
Oh, they are. They're staying on the field. It's 4th and 15, mind you. This is crazy, but
very interesting decision. You have a Dan Campbell type thing, and there's a timeout.
Timeout, yeah.
Looks like they might have heard us.
I wonder if they still go for it. Maybe they figure that, you know, this is pretty much a punt. This is pretty much pretty deep in their own side of the field. You know, so even if they turn it over here, Tigers got to go a long way down the field.
You could kick it from there. You could kick it from there, realistically.
I feel like this is kind of teetering on high school range, like the 30-yard line.
Yep, this is almost regular kick range for a field goal. So I wouldn't say regular, maybe a little bit above regular, but it's still possible. I could see them just kicking it. You should take the 3 points because you're already up 11.
Yeah, I feel like by level, I feel like the mark on which you should be able to hit consistently goes up by 10. So high school, I would say it's about 20. Then college, 30. Then NFL, you should be hitting from 40.
Just like Joey Sly, 63.
Oh, yeah. Big kick there. It was a big kick, but, you know, obviously, Patriots are still not a great team.
at least we have a bright spot.
What? One spot? No, I'm just
kidding. He said bright. He's like only one. But
one bright spot, yeah.
But, let's concentrate on the game on hand, shall we?
Plenty of season left for the Patriots, but, you know, we'll see with them. But fourth and 15 here. After the Franklin timeout, they will snap it. Pressure does come. He's going to loft it in the air, and it is incomplete down the field. Tigers will take over at the 28.
That was a huge incompletion. I mean, if the DB or safety was anywhere just low, that would have been the catch. That was an outstanding coverage by Morgan Wilson. Outstanding coverage. He stayed right on his man. Did not allow him to see that ball.
All right, now this is the possession where I think you got to get points.
Oh, yeah. No, this is a must-score possession. If you don't score on this, it's not looking great.
Yeah, because then you're looking at a lot deeper into the game when you get the ball back next.
This is one where you at least need to get a field goal, at the very least. Obviously, you want to go for the touchdown, as that's the goal of football.
Yep.
But a field goal would be acceptable if you can get a quick defensive possession done.
Franklin's defense switching around the field. Keenan will drop back in the shotgun. He's going to try and run it himself. He's drilled. It is incomplete as he tries to dump it off.
Hey, he got hit. He still had his target. I mean, he almost got that. He almost got that to Adamko. You got to give it to him. He accepted the pressure pretty well. It was the same thing that happened, I believe, last quarter or two quarters ago, where the ball just hit the ground first.
That was, as they say, a hospital ball thrown. Yeah, he would have been drilled right away if he caught that. But Keenan was also drilled on that play, so not a great play for the health of the players.
Nope.
And blitz coming from Franklin, but they will run it outside with profit. He is ran about 7 yards, but there are oohs and ahs from the sidelines. Probably the big hit there.
Crowd love that.
And the band is going nuts, man.
Hey, we're trying our best as we see Mello sub in. Looks like
there's two student sections. One just has drums.
Adamko subs out, it looks as if. That was either him or number 11. As the offense looks to get underway.
It's 3rd and 3 here for Dylan Keenan and the offense. Snap to him. It's a keep by Keenan. And he might be a bit short. He might have got it. We'll see what the ruling is from the refs.
Maybe they bring
it. And it's
a
first down as they rule it.
I thought they're going to bring out the chain game for that one. That was pretty close.
And it is. That's very good for another Tiger first down.
We did see the chain gang come out in the Durfee game once.
Yep. Gotta respect the chain gang.
Yeah. They have not came out on the field yet, but, you know, obviously they're still doing their job over there. It's just at some points it is more important than others. But visibly to the refs, at least, he got the first. And Tigers are moving, but they got to do it with pace as there's less than 10 minutes to go.
We could see Lester.
Keenan's going to launch it deep. It is caught. No one's going to catch him. Touchdown, Tigers.
That is what you want in this situation. 9 minutes left. The comeback is available.
What a throw from Keenan. And the lights go off, baby.
Keenan to Escobales, as it seems. That was a beautiful throw. I mean, he had the perfect amount of air on that. Perfect spiral. Ran it right to the house. That was wonderful.
Awesome play.
Everyone is hyped. You see a Taunton bench. They are walking over to where our guys are at. That is, I mean, how could you not get pumped up from that? That was beautiful.
I'm telling you, man, one play just gets you right back in the game. That's the game of football.
Look at that. Well, they have plenty of time to now make the comeback.
This is what I would say. They're going for two. Try and get it without a field goal. As big as the touchdown was, I think this is even bigger.
Oh, yeah.
Try and pull it within just a field goal as opposed to trying to get in the end zone again.
What a throw. I mean, I can't get over that throw. That was beautiful.
Absolutely.
Escobales ran the perfect route, got himself wide open on that, seems like a deep corner.
Yeah.
Deep corner that he turned to a streak. That was just wonderful. And Keenan to hit him with a perfect amount of height and velocity in that ball.
Used the speed to cut the corner. Too fast.
Cut the corner, went straight.
And the DB could not catch up. Yeah, is this a timeout by Taunton? It might be.
And a timeout on the field.
And it is.
Taunton. In this evening's contest.
Now I believe Taunton only has one more timeout, which could be important later.
It could be.
Yeah, only one timeout.
That timeout called in a third might be, could be the game changer.
Yes. They only have one more timeout to stop the clock.
Arvin, that you might have to rely on going out of bounds. But they were able to get that. Can't stop talking about that touchdown. They're able to get it. And now all of a sudden it's 9-14. Just like that, the game is in very much reach.
Huge two-pointer coming up.
Oh, yeah, you got to score this one. Once you score this one, we might be in for a great game.
Here we go. So it looks as if Prophet is in the backfield. Escobal is on the right. Neef also on the right. And this is going to be a rollout from Keenan. He's going to throw it to the corner of the end zone. Incomplete. Yeah, you needed that one. But that's frustrating to not get that.
That is frustrating.
Let's not take away too much from the touchdown.
You cannot.
Big play.
Now the game is in reach. It went from 3-14 where it seemed like, this game might be in bed. But now it's 9-14, and all of a sudden, Taunton might win this one. If they can get a quick defensive possession done, and they just click in on offense, this will be a Taunton win.
It's also remind you that Franklin does have a great run game.
They do.
And they can just convert to that any time and just like keep running down the clock and keep getting first downs. This has been a great team all night for them. We'll see if the Tigers can put the strings together and get the ball back.
That's the main goal, and honestly, we might see them maybe lay harder hits. We might see tighter defense on the wide receivers. We might see anything to try to force that turnover. As the band is putting on a nice drum line. My commentating partner getting very, very, pretty dancey to this.
I'm into the game now.
Oh, yeah.
Dudley. With the low kick once again, it's going to be recovered at the 10. And there's extracurricular activity going on at the 40-yard line.
Extracurricular activity. I like that one. I'm stealing that one from you just to let you know. But that was a good run. I mean, it started off at like the 15. He got himself to the 25 around, give or take, 23.
And a return to the 23-yard line.
Oh, I called that one.
I couldn't take my eyes off of what was happening. I mean, I was calling the run at first, but then
That's like a
you know, you can't help but notice things.
Kind of zoned out a little bit.
Well, here we go now. And Franklin will take over. And let's see if the Tigers can quickly get the ball back, which is exactly what they need.
Let's see.
Franklin is deep in their own end, in their own zone.
And that's about, exactly what they want.
Yep, 22-yard line.
We can see, looks like it was 85 trying to hype up his team as Franklin wants to get something done here.
Oh, false start on Franklin.
There we go. Oh.
Moving back.
And a flag on the field.
Ton is loving these flags right now.
Yeah. They're
loving these flags.
We have been saying good things about the Franklin offense, but you know the penalties they've been happening all night. Yeah.
All stars may be getting a little bit. It's always after scores as well, so we might get a little bit too hyper after a score.
Yeah. Here's going to be the handoff to the right.
21 again with the carry.
It's a decent gain there to about the 30-yard line.
Our PA announcer getting pretty annoyed with the carry from Franklin.
That'll bring up second down.
Second down. I mean, you stop him two more times, and the ball is right back in your possession.
See, the thing is with the people standing outside the gate, like, I could visibly see many seats open.
Yeah, so why don't you just walk in?
Like, come on.
You're wasting money.
You're only doing yourself harm. Like, just keep those legs good. Come on, sit down. I mean, I know it's bleachers and not padded seats or nothing, but it's still a
better
seat.
Better than standing.
So, yeah, that's what
Unless
I... Unless
you're us, we love standing.
Yeah, we are as... Oh, fumble! Fumble! Who has it is the question.
See. This is big for Ton if they got it.
Oh, one of the refs pointing Ton's side. Let's see what the ruling is. And the Panthers hold on. But it is third down for Franklin.
Hey, better than nothing, you know. They got that third down that they could have been came a first and the ball rolled in the wrong direction. But...
Well, it's out of nowhere. I thought it was regular run, and the ball just flies in the air.
I thought it was a lateral. I thought it was a very long lateral.
Yeah, that was very dangerous.
That would be a pretty funny lateral. Miami Miracle-esque.
Yeah, they're very lucky. They got that one back, but now
back in their weird formation.
They're trying to get a first down, and they will. First down, Franklin. More time comes off the clock.
Not what Ton wants. Ton just wants, they want as much time as possible to make a run downfield. And that for going back to that weird formation, the one that seemingly nobody likes except for them.
Yeah, they did have a chance to get the ball at a great spot, but Franklin stayed composed and the ball was in the air. They got it back, and now they're wasting more time.
Oh, yeah. Starting to think that timeout in the third might have been a little bit premature, as they could need that timeout.
They could, but we are not quite there yet. We are at 6 minutes left. Under 2 minutes, that could be a concern, as this is a sweet pass, handoff, and he is still being pushed. I believe he's pushed by Taunton. Like he's getting pushed forward by Taunton. It's not what you want to do.
No, not really.
But yes. He got a pretty decent gain there. About 7 yards.
That formation, they went back to it, and it's working again. No matter how many times you call it weird, they seem to just go back to it.
Yeah.
You'd hope our insultation of it would eventually work.
Well, I've been saying unique. I have.
It is unique, but I'm calling it weird.
He's calling it weird. He calls it what he wants to, folks. I'm the positive one. As Franklin... on second and two, looks to pick up another first, as this is going to be a keep by the quarterback, and another first down. Yeah, they were switching quarterbacks. This time it was Terrell. Yeah, he seems to be the one to run it himself. Yeah, they have the two quarterbacks. They can switch off.
That might be a bad decision by them, though, because I think if Tollins sees that quarterback come out, they're going to expect the QB run.
That could also work in Franklin's
favor,
like if they hand it off.
Yeah, but we're thinking it in terms of how it will help the defense.
Terrell is back out there as
ball at the 48-yard line.
Manchetto watches from the sidelines. And here they go again. It is a handoff. And he breaks away from the Taunton defense. That's a touchdown.
All green, right to the end zone.
And that is heartbreaking for Taunton.
That's Frollo again.
Number 21, Andrew Frollo.
Frollo, I've been pronouncing it wrong the whole time. Frollo.
You're doing your best.
I am doing my absolute best. He gets a score, and now the game is not looking good again.
Yeah.
That is rough. That is a heartbreaker. That is an absolute heartbreaker, heart sinker, whatever you want to call it.
I know it hurts to say this, but I felt like a big play was coming from Franklin, and there it was. The field goal is good. And now the Tigers look at 21-9. Which is much different than 14-9.
Where did the football even go? It went beyond the goalpost, right into the track.
And this is not a good sign when you see people leaving. Yeah,
no.
Yeah, you don't want to see that.
No, that puts a team at some unmotivation. I mean,
yep, some are starting to disperse after that.
Well, maybe they weren't fans in the first place, and the people up here, people around us, we support the Taunton Tigers entirely.
Yeah, the student section is dedicated to be there. The other people, however, are starting to leave.
You're fake.
Yeah, I figured, they're cold. Yeah.
Stick of your team.
Yeah, 5 minutes left. Tigers gonna have to get a quick score, stop, and then another score. Excuse me. Yeah.
The only way you can really get this game into reach is if you score this possession and get a turnover to next.
It's gonna be tough to overcome now, as the Franklin offense just is.
They've just been running. They've been
great, yeah.
It's been Frollo. He's just been the guy. It's just nothing else I can say. It's redundant as they kick it off.
Like the emphasis there. As this is caught at about the 6, it'll be returned. And wow, Franklin blows it up. Oh, but he breaks the tackle. He's going to turn up field. It's going to be out of the 20, but that was good.
Hey,
that was good.
Turned something out of nothing.
Yeah, good special teams from Franklin there.
Yep.
As the Tigers. Oh, ref dropped the ball. It's all right. Taunton Tigers. Yeah, Taunton Tigers really need a score here to keep someone in it.
See here as the huddle. I believe they might be discussing a deep game plan. You know, we might want to start outside runs, mid routes. This is that stuff they might want to start.
Under 5 minutes remaining.
You know, I should have brought a beanie, as my my attire does not have a hood.
Yeah, I came strapped.
You did. You came all prepared.
Yeah.
As I have my hands in my back pockets, hoping to stay warm.
Eventually, they will not help you, as this is a dump off to Escobar is on the left side of the field. He will turn up to the middle and get about 6 yards.
That was a tight spiral. I thought that was a deflection at one point, but it just went right for the defensive lineman's hands. Escobalos, great catch. Keenan, great throw. Give to Creds out there.
Tigers need a big play once again, as they got earlier on in the game.
As you see, more fans leave.
Keenan. I was looking at the play. Oh, yeah. Now I see it. Yep. That's really unfortunate. Yeah.
Yeah.
The fans do not have hope.
Hey, at least it'll be better traffic.
there is. You might be wondering out there, what do you mean traffic? There is traffic.
Oh, there's bad traffic.
Yeah, it's not like a stadium where there's multiple exits.
There's only one.
You
either go through it or you slug through it.
Yeah.
But there's a game at hand. You got to focus on the now.
I believe there's 3 exits to Taunton High. There's the main one.
There's also 4 receivers lined up as Keenan is ready to throw it.
Yep, Keenan. Off to the left. That is a tough drop. Yeah, Dorno dropped that one, yeah.
Hey, he doesn't drop him too common, though. It just so happened to happen at the worst possible time. That is bad. That I shouldn't say bad. That's heart-wrenching. That is just sad.
Yeah, it's now it's
it hurts.
4th and 3. If they don't convert here, it is pretty much all said and done.
Unfortunately. You know, it was looking like an exciting game, but
it was. Yeah. But, you know, Franklin just kind of prevailed at the end.
Yeah, this will be a tough loss. If it ends up a loss, you never know what can happen, like we've said.
Tiger offense stays on the field as they go.
Odds are not looking in the Tigers' favor, though.
No, it is not.
I think is what you mean.
It is not.
Here we go, 4th and 3. Keenan in the shotgun. He's going to throw it quickly,
throw.
And I believe that. Oh, he dropped it. Oh, I thought he caught it. Nope, that's going to be a drop from Duverna. And this will be a turnover.
That is tough, and they gave him too good a field position.
Yep, that's what I was going to say. Yep, great field position. And now I think it's when we'll start seeing fans exit.
Yeah, as the cheerleaders are trying their best to keep the people to stay with hyperactivity. But they are leaving anyway. As the PA announcer tells people to not litter, we'd also appreciate that. Do not litter. Care about planet Earth.
After tonight's contest. Apparently we're doing public service announcements now.
The PA announcer was. I'm going to hop on this train. spread the positive message. As the Franklin offense. I forgot.
No need for special teams when you turn it over on downs.
Hey, why not punt it 1st and 10? Give him a shot.
Yeah, the Tigers are going to pinch their defense onto the line, but this will be ran outside by Franklin. Probably about 5 yards.
As it was Sidwell, he had possession of the ball.
Oh, there's a helmet down. But it's quickly picked up.
Cole Sidwell with the carry again for the Panthers.
Only less than 4 minutes to go here.
Yeah, it's I think this is when we might see some more chewing of the clock. By Franklin. This is when they probably make their offense so slow and draggy.
Yeah, tough loss here tonight.
Hey, you never know if it's a loss. They're still it ain't over till it's over. 3 minutes, 26 seconds on the clock. You never know what can happen.
I do understand you are trying to be as positive as possible.
I am.
Big tackle from Duverna. The one who dropped the could-have-been first down last time.
I feel like I should say the tables have turned as you accused me of not being a positive one, but now I'm being a positive one. I keep receipts.
Whatever, man. It's just I'm not paying attention. I'm not keeping track of who's saying what.
But, let's focus at the game at hand, as I've said several times. All business.
Terrell in at quarterback.
Let's see, haven't
seen much of Blanchetto.
Called it.
As this is an quarterback run. And he's gonna go outside. He's gonna get in the end zone.
That is the game.
Wow.
All the positivity is drained. That is probably what puts it to bed.
Great run there from the quarterback. Yeah, that's as we've learned, what his purpose is on this team, and he does it well.
I identified it by just seeing the number. I knew that was going to be a QB run. Yeah, that's tough. That is a tough pill to swallow.
And now we're going to be looking at 28-9.
Why couldn't it be 28-3?
Yeah. Well, all right, let's take away Taunton's points then. Yep, kick is going
to
be good.
Hey, but 28-3 is just the cursed score.
Don't think it's much time left. Yeah, 28-9, 2:28 to go.
Under 2:30 remaining. Yeah, Taunton's going to need a kick return, a turnover, quick touchdown to make this close. A very, very specific set of goals right there that are equally as unlikely as they are strange to point out.
Yeah.
As we have a stoppage in the action, both teams.
So Franklin's next game will be home. They're home, yeah. Versus Attleboro at 6:30.
And Taunton's next game will be. Taunton's next game will be a King Philip. It'll be away, the second league game.
That is correct. And this will be a tough loss for Taunton tonight.
Oh, yeah.
See,
maybe we can get something going here. And
nope. Gets drilled at the 20-yard line.
Yeah, that is so.
Taken across the 20, big hit by.
Yep, so this is going to be now a four-game winning streak for Franklin. Boy, are they are rolling.
Oh, yeah, they're on fire.
They're on fire.
Unfortunately, we got right into the trenches of their win streak.
Yep, their confidence only going up now. And
why couldn't we go against them in their first game where they kind of struggled a little bit?
Yeah, Taunton, yeah, as you mentioned right there, that Taunton has been going through a rough patch, yeah, and this is only going to add on to it.
Yep.
Unfortunately.
But, we still got the season ahead. I'm sure we can turn things around eventually. As they're hoping for a prayer here.
2:20 left in the game. Yeah, as we were talking about the timeout earlier. I don't think they're going to need that.
Yeah. At the time I said it, seemed pretty necessary, but.
Yep. Keenan's going to throw it to the left side to DuVerna. He's going to turn upfield. He's going to get a first down. He's going to get a bit more. He's going to be fighting.
That's out of bounds.
Down the sideline. Great. Great play there.
Stop the clock.
Big game.
Hey, I mean, plays like that, it can put this game right back into grip. A small grip, but it can put it back into grip.
I mean, when the game is looking really tough, the game is looking pretty much like it's going to be a tough loss, you just want to end it off on some good momentum.
Yep, of course.
And
bring it to the next game.
And the hope right now is just that Tigers can build some momentum going into the next game.
Good run.
Get in the end zone, maybe, as that's going to be a run from profit. We are now under 2 minutes to go here.
Yep.
Blasts his way down to the 40-yard line.
Another fun game. They got a great environment.
Yep. I mean, the fans are good up until right about now.
Yeah, I can't exactly blame them. You know, you want to beat the traffic, as they say.
Yep.
Yeah, you want to beat that. You want to get
second
your warm house.
Yeah, in this cold weather.
Yeah, run
they
from
run
profit.
A play right there.
Yeah, run from profit. Carry. Might be a bit short of the first down, but yep.
Yeah, this was a tough game. I mean, it was close. For a long time, and then this fourth quarter, Franklin just seemed to get out the gates quick. We actually went out the gates and didn't even go back near them. They continued to distance themselves from the gates.
The gates shut behind them. And they locked on their own.
A padlock appeared as Keenan hands it off.
Yep, running up the middle.
Good run.
Yep, good run from Profit.
Trying to get that momentum, bring it into next game. As the clock stops, so there's a timeout.
Yep, out of the 40. It's going to be a timeout. Or a little stoppage in play. Clock will stop for some reason. I'm not sure why the clock will stop there. No timeout was called, but
guess
it doesn't really matter. 30 seconds
clock
left.
Stop figured. It looks like they're just going to let it
yep.
run.
Well, Keenan and the shotgun here. They're going to go for the end zone. He might have him here. And it's incomplete.
Yeah, that was. He got the receiver got hit a little bit too hard to really come down to that one, but it was a good throw by Keenan. He had his target on that one.
I feel like, even if he caught that, he might have been out of bounds. He was leading very close to that line.
Got to do a toe drag.
Heading to play King Philip.
As the PA announcer is now announcing it as if it is the end of the game, as probably is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably this might be the last play. I mean, unless they do another pass. But
they could do a kneel. You know, they might just respectfully accept defeat. But that wouldn't be cool. We'd much prefer to see a good throw.
That looks like what we're going to get here, as there's four receivers on the outside.
It's a vertical route. Keenan drops back.
It's going to go to the right. It's going to be caught.
That is a good catch.
Yeah, but, you know, not much gain there.
Hey, but you still get the momentum as the clock runs down. There's a timeout.
Timeout by who? Who's the timeout by?
Sidwell.
Time by Taunton, yep. I guess they're trying to get in the end zone.
Get the touchdown, you know, bringing that momentum to the next game, and especially against a team like King Philip, you need to have all the momentum you need. I always hear about them.
That is the last timeout for Taunton. I don't believe Franklin used any of theirs.
No, I don't.
Yep.
They didn't.
Yeah, I don't think
necessarily they have to.
Yeah, they didn't have to. Their goal was just to run the clock.
As Taunton just looks to score a touchdown here, you know, get some momentum for the next game.
Ocho segundos. Spanish, everybody? Spanish?
No, Spanish. Mm-hmm. I didn't exactly understand what it meant.
Oh, you didn't? Really?
Nope. No, I didn't pay attention in Spanish 1 or 2.
Okay, well.
I probably shouldn't have moved that over camera because that probably puts my college chances very low.
All right, Keenan drops back. He's going to throw it over the middle. It's going to be intercepted. And let's see. This one's going to be returned by Frank. Oh, it's a big tackle.
Oh, that's a good hit.
Big tackle from DuVerna.
Good hit.
And the clock will run out. And Taunton will lose 28-9 to the hands of the Franklin Panthers. And they will drop to 2-3. Franklin will go to 4-1. Aiden, this was a rough game for the Tigers all around. Great game for Franklin. What do you think went wrong here?
Towards the first three quarters, I want to say the defense I taught is very good. But towards that early point of the fourth, it just kind of started to fall behind a little bit. Maybe they ran out of energy. You know, it happens. But it was a relatively close game the whole way. Really, I think Taunton probably did the best. They had a good effort. You cannot take that away from Taunton. It's just that Franklin just so happened to have a running back who seems to be able to get through everybody, and you just can't do anything about that.
Yeah, he was a great player, and Taunton, when they got that touchdown, they looked good. But after that, obviously, all Franklin. But that'll do it for us tonight. Second home game of the year, second game here in Iowa Voices.
How wonderful.
Yes. 28-9, Panthers win, and we will see you next time.